Hey guys, I'm Paul Bridgewater. Welcome to SnapComms, where you bring your news in a snap. In the studio today, I have Mr. Trevor Bridgewater from the Ministry of Health and Social Development, and we're going to be talking about the Participatory Poverty Assessment and how that assessment aims to improve the lives of families in the Virgin Islands. Welcome to the show.
Thank you.
So, Trevor, why is it important for people to participate in this Participatory Poverty Assessment?
People are the most important resource for this assessment. I say that to say the assessment is geared towards improving the lives of persons in the territory, and you community members actually have a say, an important say, as it relates to getting the information to us so that we could make recommendations with the report that is going to be done at the end.
So what kind of data are you guys really looking for with this PPA?
Well, data includes, the kind of data actually is interviews with community experts in the communities, actually case studies, focus groups. Those are the kind of data, qualitative data, actually information from members in the community.
Right. Okay, so once completed, would there be like a report for people to browse too for themselves to see the results that you guys found?
Right. So yes, the answer is yes. But before that happens, the report has to be done, and then a consultation is done within the communities that we worked with, and then therefore the final report would be made available to the public.
Okay. So a little bit about this PPA. For people that don't know, how has this PPA benefited other countries? And if you know any, what are some countries that have benefited from this PPA?
Right. So there were several countries in the Caribbean that had actually done this exercise, all in an effort to improve the lives of their citizens. These countries include Anguilla, Antigua and Barbuda, also Saint Kitts and Nevis, Dominica. Right. So they have actually, I know for Saint Kitts, they have actually done a household stipend where once eligible, you get a monthly stipend, all in an effort to improve the lives of that specific household.
Mm-hmm. All right, so it sounds like it's a really good thing that's on the way. Mm-hmm. And if anyone sees Trevor at that door, basically, you know, answer the door and help him to help you. So is there anything else you would like to add for the people that, you know, are watching?
Well, I'd just like to say, you know, just be open, be actively engaged in the process, because it's about you getting the information from you, seeing that you're on the ground. This is a grassroots exercise, and, you know, just be engaged. You know, we are recovering from the 2017 disasters, and this information is crucial so that we could actually make the informed decisions or recommend the informed decision to make the informed decision so that we can improve the lives of persons in the territory.
All right. So thanks for stopping by.
Thank you.
That's it for today, guys. I'm Paul Bridgewater signing off. Be sure to tune in for your daily feed of SnapComms, so you bring your news in a snap.
Subscribe to our YouTube channel, Twitter, and Facebook at BVI Government, and Instagram at GISBVI.